results are coming into the newsroom, and we can now say Mayor Michael Hancock has been elected to his third term in office. Thanks for joining us at 10. I'm Matt Morrow.
And I'm Erica Gonzalez. Challenger Jamie Giellis conceded just about a half hour ago, and this is a look at where those results currently stand right now. You see Hancock right there leading with 56% of the vote.
Our team is currently embedded with both campaigns. Tonight we begin with Fox 31's Michael Konopasek, who is at the Hancock headquarters. Michael?
Yeah, what a night it was when we first arrived here at the EXO Event Center. Supporters weren't sure what would happen, but oh, how that mood has changed. Here is a look as this party does start to wind down now here at the EXO Event Center. There was major concern that Hancock would lose as his former challengers threw their support behind Jamie Giellis, but Hancock has prevailed tonight. It was an impressive victory to a third term after facing criticism over the cost of living here in Denver and being caught up in a Me Too movement scandal. With his wife and children by his side, Hancock thanked his supporters and vowed to unite Denver as he moves into a third term. Now, Mayor Hancock spoke to me just moments after receiving a call from his challenger, Jamie Giellis, conceding that race. Let's listen. Yeah, Jamie Giellis just made that call a short time ago, and here is Mayor Hancock. Again, congratulations on your victory. I guess the big question would be, a lot of people voted for Jamie. How are you going to unite Denver now that you have four more years?
Listen, the election's over. Right now, it's about making sure Denver remains united, comes back together, and focuses on moving forward. And so we're going to go forward with the strategies that we've been putting in place to address all the challenges of the people of this great city. And I represent everybody, even those who voted for Jimmy, and I'm proud to do so. And I don't have a problem sitting down with everyone to say, how do we continue together to move the city forward?
And in attendance here this evening is former Colorado governor and current presidential candidate John Hickenlooper. As you can see, people still here at the EXO Event Center. Of course, there was a lot of dancing, the alcohol, the drinks were flowing here, and people were having a good time. But things are starting to wrap up. Now we'll send it back to you in the studio.
All right, Michael, thank you very much. Meanwhile, challenger Jamie Giellis, she was addressing the crowd at her campaign party just about an hour ago. Fox 31's Greg Nieto is joining us from her watch party with what she had to say tonight. Of course, she lost, Nieto, so what is she telling us?
Yeah, Erica, much different vibe here at Ophelia's near the heart of lower downtown Denver. In a sit-down interview with Jamie Giellis, she says two factors led her, unfortunately, to the result she was not hoping for. Two factors, name recognition and also money. We sat down with her shortly after she made that concession phone call to Mayor Michael Hancock, and we also talked about the negative campaign. The fact I asked her that she ran a much different campaign leading up to the runoff election, and then once it was in the runoff season, the campaign on both sides became negative. She simply says, getting into a negative campaign, it's a lot easier to get into one, not easy to get out of one.
It very quickly went negative, and the truth is, again, it was very hard to get out from underneath that. We kept trying to talk about the issues, but it was very hard to bring the issues up when I was facing commercials and flyers and social media ads. It was coming at us pretty fast.
Live look here at Jamie Giellis as she is really sending out a whole lot of thanks and hugs to the supporters who came down to Ophelia's to support her. She says her tenure as someone running for public service is not over here. She says she will continue to do her civic duty and try to make Denver an even better place. Live here in Lodo, Greg Nieto, Fox 31.
All right, Greg, thank you very much.